1,941 gills, 3,882 boobs. This video blog features neither, although some people say that I am the biggest tit on YouTube. Hey, I'm Chris Williams, and welcome to my video blog for the 27th of April 2010. After the obligatory advert for my sister's sticker business, I'm going to talk about crime and politics and libel laws. But first of all, if you are of a nervous disposition, please look away until you have finished hearing me speak over the distressing picture that is about to appear. It is a picture that appeared in the popular media here in the United Kingdom in 2009, but I know that some of you might not wish to see it, so just listen to the audio, and then when you hear the opening scenes to my video blog, then feel free to look back at your computer screen. At the inquest in London yesterday, hearing about the deaths of the victims in the 2005 London bombings, it was revealed to the court that of the 52 innocent people who died, 17 of them did not die instantaneously. And as you can see in this picture of, it was in the newspaper some time ago, but this is from inside the carriage, where the most fatalities happened, and I think you'll agree with me that the carriage, if you've ridden on the London Underground, the carriage looks like how it normally does. So, the carriage with the most fatalities, but not all that much damage apart from the roof and some parts of the floor, it's fair to say. So, I hope that this communicates the message that terrorism is rare, and when it does happen, there are few fatalities. Only 52 people died in the London bombers. It could have been a lot worse. Thankfully, it wasn't. And the damage caused by the explosives did not destroy the carriages. Obviously, this carriage here is no longer usable because of its damaged roof. But you see what I mean, that the seats are still in place, the poles that you hold onto in the carriage, they're largely still intact. So, although there was obviously a massive force from the blast, the wreckage is not unrecognisable. So, this sends out the message that terrorists are being beaten regularly. You know, their plans to engage in mass murder are often thwarted before they can be activated, and when they do slip through the net, they are not as effective as they would like to be. They don't kill as many people as they would like, and they don't cause as serious injuries to people as what they would like. And the images of the wreckage caused by their explosives make you wonder just how powerful was the blast, because it seems that the blast was not all that powerful for the damage to not seem to be extreme. My condolences obviously go to the families of the victims of the London bombings, and obviously my thoughts to those who were injured in those attacks. I say that in this video where I'm going to be talking about crime. Ironic that I've got a brochure from a newspaper about crime statistics, and what's quite funny is that it's about crime and I stole it from the library, so that's crime. But it's okay to steal newspapers from libraries, you know, but they had them lying all over the place, and then at the end of the day, then throw them in the bin, so they're not gonna miss this. Right, so on the theme of murder, let's talk about the crime statistics. There's loads of statistics in here, but we're strapped for time. Obviously, London has the largest
murder percentage contributing towards overall crime in that particular area. In the Metropolitan Police area, 20.6% of crime is murder, and then the most murderous place in terms of percentages after that is Gwent, 23.1%. Here in Cardiff, South Wales Police area, 8.1% is murder. Back home in Pembrokeshire, 13.7% of crime is murder. West Midlands, so Birmingham area, 19.5% of crime is murder. Merseyside, 20%. In England and Wales in total, 12% of crime is murder. 71% of all murder victims in the United Kingdom are male. 20% of all murders are committed by a former partner. 6% of all murders are committed by a son or a daughter. And 30% of all murders are committed by a stranger. I suppose that those stranger murders are probably done by people with psychological issues. You know, those who are released from mental health facilities and have not been taking their medication or have escaped from the mental health facility. As you might know, I have Asperger's syndrome, so I receive treatment from the local mental health facility here. Obviously, I'm not on medication, I'm perfectly safe to be around. But this brings me on to another topic, libel laws. But as you might know, I've been bullied on Facebook by someone who sent me abuse. I posted it on YouTube for my viewers to see. And some people have asked me, is what I'm doing a breach of libel? Well, I've done my research, no it isn't. If I say someone is bullying me, but don't provide evidence, then that is slander, defamation, libel, whatever you want to call it. Defamation is the definitive word for legal terms. Apparently, libel is a loose term. If you want to take a call, it's defamation that you're wanting. But because I provided proof to back up my statement that I was being bullied, and you have seen that proof, in the court of public opinion, I am stating a fact. I'm not making an allegation. I am illustrating a fact to you, which is a true fact. So, it's my understanding that means that I have not committed any breach of defamation or libel, as you might call it. I think this might be my last video book before the UK general election. After this, until the election, it's going to be written blogs, I think, but I might be pushed for time. But very brief, I want to say, apparently, according to the newspaper, 38% of those questions say that they still haven't decided who they're going to vote for. And here are some interesting numbers. The Conservatives will get as low as 27 and as high as 37. Labour, as low as 18, as high as 33. And the Liberal Democrats, as low as 23 and as high as 40, according to an opinion poll in the Guardian newspaper. Where the Conservatives are concerned, 13% of their supporters might be inclined to switch to Labour, 46% might switch to the Liberal Democrats. Where Labour is concerned, 19% of their supporters might go Conservative, 59% might switch to the Liberal Democrats. And for the Liberal Democrats, 30% of their supporters are willing to go to the Conservatives, and 33% are willing to go to Labour. So, that shows that the recent surge in Liberal Democrat popularity is from disenchanted Labour voters. But equally, it's a concern for the Conservatives that half of their less than half of their voters who are undecided as to if they're definitely going to vote Conservative are willing to go to the Liberal Democrats. And for the Liberals, you know, one third of their voters are willing to go to the Conservatives, another third are willing to go to the Liberals. So, interesting numbers there. Okay, until the election, I might have time to do other video blogs during the run-up to the election, but if I don't, I hope you vote for the correct party, and it might be a lot of fun analysing the figures as I get to time. Okay, until next time, it's bye for now, but do check out my written blog, musingsofchristmas.blogspot.com, during my absence from YouTube, to keep up to date with my philosophical thoughts. Okay, until next time, it's bye for now. Bye bye.